Now being road transport is more important than railway transport due to the following reasons. These reasons maybe have some kinds, so that the road transport is more important than the railway transport. What are the reasons? How could we say the rail transport is important than in comparison to railway transport? Their topic point of comparison will be here. First one is cost of construction. Cost of construction, it means that in during the building or the spreading the network of road and railway transport both, we have need some money to construct the road and railway. During that construction, in road transport, we have less money to construct the road in comparison to railway transport. In railway transport, have high investment during the construction of railway transport. So that the low cost, high benefit for the road transport, and low cost, high cost, low benefit at the railway transport. That's why the road transport is important than railway transport on the basis of cost of construction. Now we shall construction area. In which area we have constructed the road, railway, and other way of communication. So we focus construction area like uneven or even surface. We have already factor affecting development of railway network topography. The topographic and natural landscape will also have hampered the development of railway income. But road transport also easily constructed at the even and uneven surface. Even they have many road constructed at the sloppy and the hilly area easily in comparison to railway transport. But so that's why the construction easily at the even and uneven both surfaces, but the road transport but not railway transport. So that's why the it also have a reason to road transport is more important than the railway transport. Now we shall third point, cost effective. Cost effective, it means that road transport of transport goods and services from one place to another place for small distance is highly beneficial, but long distance road highly beneficial. Here railway is beneficial. So that's the point to cost effective means it also has a point to constitute that road transport is more important than the railway transport. So that's the why cost effectiveness of the road transport is more in comparison to railway transport is more important than the railway transport. Now the road. Road is the only means of transport which provides the links between the other means of transport. But railway could not have capacity to provide the link between the other means of transport. So that's why the road transport is important than the railway transport. Now the road transport also provides the door service, but railway could not have capacity to provide the road service because transport providing the service and the road transport provides the road service. It means we have easily connect the old road, the road through road to other road of or other means of transport. Like if we have directly connected directly connected via road to other means of communication, but railway track and other means of communication are not directly linked to over home road. So that's why the old road is providing the over home road service. So easily it will be, that point will be emphasized on that road important, transport is more important than the railway transport due to that following reasons. Here first, second, third, fourth, fifth, they are all are making the road transport importance in comparison to railway transport. So that's why the railway transport is less important than the road transport, or road transport is more important than the railway transport vice versa. So that's why these are the transport is the important sector of service sector, transport is the basis to development the other sector of economy. It provides means to development of other sector of economy. So that's why the land transport, air transport, and water transport is the part of service sector which provide the basic foundation to other means development of other sector of economy in development and betterment of that sector. So now we have already discussed land part, land transport. Within land we have discussed road transport, railway transport. Now we will focus on the pipeline transport. In the pipeline transport, we could not transport the humans, only goods and services we can transport one place to another place by the pipeline. Pipeline transport. Pipeline transport, as we say, the pipeline transport, it means the transport from one place to another place by the pipelines. In the ancient time or the modern time, we are used pipeline for the transport of water supply in city from one place to another place, from the well to door. So that pipeline use only the water supply. In but modern and contemporary period of time, it is a major part of the land transport. It have emerged a new type of transport in the mode of transport map in India, which help the transport of goods and services from one place to another place through pipeline. The pipeline transport only solid, it only molten state solid. Molten state solid and liquid transfer from one place to another place. Pipeline. But in through pipeline we cannot transport the humans from one place to another. Some kind of restriction every transport have. The, in hilly area, the railway transport could not work at that much as a road transport work. So that every transport have some kind of restriction. So that pipeline transport have restriction, not transport the humans, yeah, human resources from one place to another place. So that it's only solid and liquid part of the transport will be transport one place to another place. The pipeline in recent time or the contemporary period, pipeline transport has oil transport, crude oil, gas, or maybe called water, and other also. So these are the main transport by the pipeline transport. Crude oil, gas, water, and others will be crude oil and petroleum product transport. Petroleum products. It means these all are transport by the pipeline transport at that present time. So that transport may be effective because it transport without any kind of restriction or maybe have maintenance. Pipeline transport have one unique feature, they have low cost of maintenance. So that's why the transport, pipeline transport for solid and liquid is important transport other than the railway and road transport. So now we focus some in India have three main major pipeline transport. India have three major pipeline transport, which are three major pipeline from one place to another place transport for crude oil, petroleum products, and maybe somehow the gases for the bulk waste to another place, different type of CNG and natural gas. So all these gas are transferred one place to another place. So the three major pipeline transport, first one is from Upper Assam, it means they have oil field of Upper Assam, oil field of Upper Assam to Brunei. So it means So from Upper Assam to Brunei via Kanpur, Brunei, Kanpur and Allahabad. Okay, so like we have same example we take that in we have going to anywhere from one place to another place by the road or railway. During that origin and destination, we have some kind of distance between that place. Origin and destination, we have some kind of places are between that two points. Like in railway, we have stations, different kind of station, and in road transport, different kind of roadway platform and the private platform. These platforms are the via the origin and destination, which have goes through these particular areas. So that pipeline also started from the oil field of the Upper Assam to Brunei, Baruni and via Kanpur and Allahabad. In this pipeline have three major, that particular one pipeline have some branches to connect each other. Like in roadways have connectivity here to here, here to here, and the between that also have connectivity. That place here to here, here to here. Same like the pipeline have also have some branches to provide that between the origin and destination, split the link to other areas for their development or their transport, the solid or liquid, maybe crude oil or other things. Okay, now the important branch, Brunei to Haldia, first branch. Brunei to Haldia. First branch Brunei started from the Brunei and ended with the Haldia. The pipeline communication, pipeline transport is the one way transport because it cannot go other way vice versa. If we have flow here, he could not capability to flow here. There's some restriction already we have. So that's why the pipeline started from Brunei to Haldia. And the second pipeline was started from Rajbandh to the Mauri Gram. Okay, the second branch was branches Brunei to Haldia, Rajbandh to Mauri Gram. Okay, now the third branch is Guwahati to Siliguri. Okay, these are the three important branch of that particular pipeline. If pipeline start Upper Assam to Brunei and via Kanpur and Allahabad, and three branches are constitute that particular pipeline. So here the pipeline started, first pipeline and branches have here. Now we shall move another pipeline. Another pipeline started from Salawa to Virabha. Vikram. Sorry, not Vikram, Virabha. So now the second pipeline started from the Slava to Virabhadra. It was started from the Gujarat and ended with the Surat Jalandhar. Started from Gujarat to Jalandhar. Okay, via it also have via Mathura, Delhi. Okay, this pipeline goes through, started from the Gujarat and ended with the Jalandhar Punjab via Mathura and Delhi. It also has some kind of branches, we hold the pipeline and connected with the branches. Which provide the additional facility between the areas to provide the oil, clinker and crude oil, petroleum, gas, some gas fertilizer provide the gas, so that there are some branches here. Koyali to Chakshu. That one branch of these pipeline works Koyali to Chakshu. It provided the some kind of the transport which was transported by the this pipeline from Salwa to Virabhadra. Okay, now the second part and the last important branch of the three major pipeline transport of India. The three third branch was started from Hajira. Hajira, Gujarat. Hajira is located at the Gujarat to Jagdishpur. UP, Uttar Pradesh. Okay, to Jagdishpur and started from Hajira, Gujarat. Part of Gujarat and ended with the Jagdishpur part of the Uttar Pradesh. So this pipeline was third pipeline which was started from Hajira to Jagdishpur. It also has some connectivity and some branches in Rajasthan, Kota, Kota have also one branch of that Hajira and Jagdishpur pipeline. And the second was the Barnala and Sahajanpur, UP. Sahajanpur and Barnala, UP. It's part of the UP, Sahajanpur and the Barnala. Okay, these two branches are presented for this. Pipeline is at UP. So, Sahajanpur and Barala. Okay, so these are the three major part pipeline of transport in India at present. So, all these are the pipeline are in India. So, somehow there are some old transport have some own benefits and some constraint. We already discussed the constraint of the pipeline. It means the one-way communication and it could not transport the whole. So here we talk about the benefits of pipeline transport. Okay, now we benefit of pipeline transport. Somehow the first benefit is low cost of maintenance. Okay, it means pipeline transport has have initial investment, initial cost during the spreading of the building and network pipeline transport, but in maintenance have very low cost in comparison to other means of transport. So it involves the low cost of maintenance, that's why it was the prominent transport in India at that time, pipeline transport. And the second was the cost of maintenance, and it also has cost, low cost of the operations. Operation. It means if we have regulate that from like Hazira to Jagdishpur, the third pipeline was Hazira to Jagdishpur, Gujarat to UP. That pipeline operational cost. It means that started from Hazira to Jagdishpur, it have very low cost. If in initial we have taking cost to build the pipeline, after the building pipeline, the maintenance cost and the operational cost will be very low in comparison to other means of transport. So that's why the it's benefit of the pipeline transport. So first one, low cost of maintenance and low cost of the operational. Okay, now we that it will be transport solid molten state and liquid easily in comparison to other means of transport, because they have in other means of transport solid and liquid will be contained in the any type of container which started from here to here, but in pipeline we have given the any kind of within the same pressure, or the amount will be in amount will be high in comparison to other means of transport in liquid and solid transport by the pipeline transport will be continuous chain which was not hampered by the other means of transport, but other means of transport were they are linked to each other, so that's why the maybe restriction or hampered by the any kind of interaction. So but pipeline have continuous transport from one place to another place without any restriction. So that's why the benefit, that was benefit of the pipeline transport. So now third point was not restricted by the any weather. Not affected by weather. Weather means the outside weather. We will not affect the transport of the pipeline, transport by the pipeline, because the other means of transport was open air, and they will be affected because railway, air and water and maybe the road transport, all means of transport are affected by the outer weather and the natural phenomena. But the pipeline was not affected by the weather, any kind of climate, they have been continuous going on. So it will be, it was the benefit of the pipeline transport. It means, and then it also provides a link to PT. Helps to develop fertilizer industries which are based on gas or any crude oil and the petroleum product. It helps to develop the other part fertilizer industries. It means that it also helps in that. It also help in that. Communicate to the raw material to fertilizer industry without any restriction, or they have a continuous transport of the raw material to fertilizer industry through the pipeline transport. So, and final will be maybe here, right down here, that without in pipeline has the unique pipeline transport have unique feature to communicate or transport goods and services from one place to another place without interruption, without any kind of without any kind of kinds of interruption. Okay, without interruption, it means they have long distance without interruption. Long distance. It means that like pipeline transport, if we have started from here to here, the pipeline started from here to here. After starting here, we have to note anything. If we have stopped from here, that swipe will be stopped. Without stopping, the original part of the pipeline transport will be not affected. Without stopping here, will be not stop the other part. It will be origin or ended with the destination. In between that part, we have no any kind of restriction. We are not present. It will be without any kind of weather. He will be continuous going on. It will be continuous transport also, and other transport will be taking place, and the maybe hampered by the weather and the other kind of things. But by then we have started from continuous process of the continuous transport from one place to another place. So these are the benefit of the pipeline transport. So that's why we taking the huge pipeline transport for the oil, crude oils, petroleum products and the gas from one place to another place without any restriction or any interruption in the transport. So these are the pipeline. So we are the cover the lane transport, road transport, second railway transport, and third one is the pipeline transport. All have unique benefit and unique construction in the development of the particular lane transport. In road have some kind of restriction, they have railway also have restriction, and the pipeline also have restriction. So all kind of transport have some kind of restriction, but at the same time we have taken the benefit of that particular transport. So we have covered the lane transport completed, and now we shall move another means of transport was the water, air. The two remaining part will be covered in next lecture. So other means of transport, air and water, will be covered in next section.